My first question to you, Christina, is you're all the way in Minnesota. So what prompted you to enroll in Georgia Tech's online Master of Science in Computer Science program?
I've been a developer for 10 years, but I have no formal training in any aspect of that. I actually have a master's in chemical engineering from University of Illinois a long time ago. And the way careers do, mine sort of took a left turn at one point, and I found myself doing development sort of without the degree to back it up. I had thought about grad school previously, but I have a more than full-time job and 3 kids, and I volunteer in the community. So there is no way that even driving time would make something like that impossible. So when I heard about the online program, and given the low cost and the convenience, I just thought kind of this is an opportunity that's too good to pass up.
I want to get an idea as to what a typical week would be like for you.
Things are pretty crazy for me right now in terms of work. You know, over the course of the semester, there's enough flexibility that things can ebb and flow a little bit. Hopefully work will calm down for me pretty soon and I can start doing homework before midnight.
What would you say has been the best part of this online experience for you, or the program overall?
The first class that I took last semester was machine learning, which I found out after the fact is probably the toughest course that the program offers. At the same time, when I finished the semester, I had a real sense of accomplishment in terms of, you know, if I can conquer that class, I know I can cut it in the program. When you go off and do some research, which we had to do for a couple of papers, you know, your own experimental type research that you learn at a level that, you know, is not really possible in any other venue.
In your opinion, how would you say that this online program has changed the realm of higher education overall? How has it influenced it, you think?
Until now, the model is sort of you've got a certain number of spots, and then you look at who applies, and then you pick the right people for those spots, and everybody else is kind of out of luck. And this, the essential model change, I think, there is if you can do the work, then you can participate, which is a profound difference. From a student standpoint, it's also a difference in terms of, you know, it isn't just a matter of, do you live close enough to someplace that would offer something appropriate? And do you have the buckets of cash that it would take to, you know, dump into something like this? I got 3 kids headed for college, so there's no way an expensive program would be in the cards for me, you know? And so it sort of changes the model in terms of reducing some of those barriers. I think barriers that everybody kind of assumed were fixed are starting to fall, which is exciting.